Hey, it's nice to have you back here in this new video. Today we're gonna dive deep into one of my secret weapons in my YouTube studio. And that is the Ninja 300. The 80 watts, the COB with constant temperature of 5600K, super bright and also super portable in my hand. This Ninja 300 is very useful for the indoors and outdoor shooting as well. So before I get started, I just want to give you a disclaimer for this video. The company WeLight did send this bundle to me for free to make this video. This package includes the main light, the mini bowing adapter, the battery adapter, the mini handle, and also a nicely designed carry case. They asked me whether if I can make a video for this light because it's nicely designed and it's very bright. Just a few months ago, I have already substituted my main light in my studio into another Ninja 300. So long before the WeLight sent me this light, I have already used the Ninja 300 for quite a long time. Actually, what you have seen in my previous episode where I'm recording the indoor shooting in my YouTube studio, the main light was lit up by another Ninja 300 that I have purchased myself with a diffuser box. Here, take a look at this, the main light of my YouTube studio. You do see that. This is my main light with a diffuser box and a grid. So this video is going to represent my brutal honest review on this light in long-term use. And also with this complete new design bundle, I can also use the Ninja 300 for outdoor shooting as well. Well, before I get started, just want to show you how bright it is. Whoa. Maybe you can hear the wind noise in the fan because the fan is running inside this machine. And this is the main drawback of this Ninja 300. But for the rest of the design, I think this is perhaps the best portable the COB indoor light source for the small YouTubers like you and me. And it is cost effective, it is precise, and it is powerful for outdoor shooting as well. So now let's get started. Okay, first thing first, let's unbox the WeLight Ninja 300. That's inside the box, a portable package. A full bundle for a single person YouTuber or you just have limited persons in your studio. It's portable, it's durable, and it's very lightweight. So actually inside the package, you can see a lot of stuff. But I have already assembled the Ninja 300 for you guys. So inside the box, you have a lot of stuff. This is an AC-DC adapter that with 18 volts and 5 amps. And altogether, it has a maximum output power of 19 watts. Actually, for the rest, I have already assembled all the things for you guys right here. So wait for a moment. Let's take a full walkthrough on this Ninja 300. S1 handle that could mount Ninja 300 into a portable handle that can boost your content creation. VP05 converter to convert this Ninja 300 into a full-size bowing connector. It is very useful, especially when you have lots of low-cost, low-budget bowing softbox, especially you have a lot of light accessories like the softbox. It is a full-size bowing connector. Actually, this is the light that I have fully assembled in my hand. This is the S1 handle. It's very comfortable feel in your hand with a quarter inch mount on the bottom and also a quarter inch thread with every locating hole on the front. And here is the Ninja 300. There's a full aluminum body with internal fan and excellent heat dissipation. And on the back, you can see the LED light. There's a DC input and a Type-C port for the firmware upgrade. The mode button turn on and off and a scrolling wheel. And it can also be doubled as a button. Tap as a button. That's it. On the left, you can mount this guy. On the left, you can mount, actually you can mount this accessory. This is the WeLight WB2, the battery adapter, where you can mount two units of your Sony F960 battery to charge, to power your Ninja 300 that has a maximum 80 watts and 5600K. And first time you mount your battery, you can see your remaining battery life. You can switch into different modes. You can switch input or output. For input, you can charge through this USB-C cable, USB-C port that supports USB power delivery quick charge. You can charge the battery really, really fast. And if you switch out, these two units, to combine them together, it has a high voltage output to fully power this Ninja 300 through the DC cable right here. This is what you're gonna get inside all these boxes. Yeah, this is, and also this is a soft box. This one is attachable. And you can also mount this full size bowing connector into your Ninja 300 that you can later you can mount for the other low cost the Bowen converter for light accessories. And you can finally mount a full size soft box on the top of this Bowen connectors. Yeah, and this is very useful for your existing accessories. Actually recording with a Ninja 300 in my studio. This is the light quality of this light. And this is another one. Okay, now let's take a look at this soft box. I will turn off my main light and try to turn on the light into output, turn on the Ninja 300. So this is what we're gonna get with the diffuser box. Okay, actually you did hear a little bit sound of the internal fan, because for the Ninja 300, the latest batch of the Ninja 300, you cannot turn off the fan. But they have three options. If you long press the mode button, you do have to set up. The first setup, you can set up the different group and channels, because the Ninja 300 also supports the wireless control via the Bluetooth protocol. And you can control your Ninja 3 with your WeLight app, just like you have on the K21 and the WE9. Then tap mode button again, you can insert your a USB-C cable and connect this computer to upgrade the firmware to unlock more features. But currently there's no beta firmware, so I'm waiting for another firmware that can to fully turn off the fan in my studio. And tap mode again. Now you can change the fan speed. You have high and mid and low. So you have three different standards. If you switch to low, the maximum brightness of the light will be limited to 50%. Here you can see that the maximum brightness, the output power will be limited to 50%. So actually it's a 40 watts COB light. And if you switch back to the middle, now the maximum output will be limited to 80%. 80% it looks like 64 watts maximum output with CCT mode at a constant 5600K. And if you fully turn on the fan into the high, that you can unlock the maximum output to 100%. So finally we will receive your 80 watts maximum output. This is extraordinary if you use that a single light in outdoor shooting. But for the interior shot, normally with the main studio light, I will turn the fan option into low to get the minimum noise in my silent studio. You have to watch out when you use your Ninja 300 in your studio. Okay, we can turn off the light. And the next one, I think we can take a look at the app, because you can control the app. And also with the back panel, you tap it again, you have unlocked some light effects. Every individual spec, you can change the power output from 100% to 0%. And I can also change the speed, the normal, fast, slow. And for the scenes, you do have plenty of presets. But considering that it is only in a single temperature COB light, so sometimes I would rather use as a flash effects, just like this one. This is extraordinary in my light studio. Okay, now what you are watching right now is the screen capture for the WeLight app on my Android phone. Actually, I have set the group B in channel 1 for this Ninja 300. So you can tap the button to turn off the light, to wireless control. And into CCT mode, I can change the brightness from 0% to 100%. But it depends whether you have selected your fan noise into low, medium, and high. But with the app, you can control from 0% all the way up to 100%. But actually, on the on the light. It depends on your fan option. And next one is about this, you can turn off or turn it on. If you have plenty of V-Light products, I suggest you can set them to different group, but all of them remain as channel one, because there was six lights, you can control every one of them with a single tap on the group button. You can quickly switch in between the lights. So this is another tips if you have plenty of V-Light product. And there is no HSI mode, so you just can't change. And for scenes, it looks like the same as the control menu and the flash, firework, burst, all the way up to the Aurora. Considering you only have one color temperature, so it just does not work as extraordinary as the RGB light. But it doesn't matter, as at least we have amazing flash effects that for most of use cases, I've used the light as a flash effect. And this light is also very useful if you are shooting outdoors, because you can take your light with the handle, with double battery, with the battery charger, DC cable, all the things very lightweight. And for 360 capture, you can also use the light to capture some signature looking in your virtual tour photos. So that is the reason why I want to explore the potential of this new 300 light and to take a look at, to try whether I can, what I can create in my YouTube studio. Actually, what you are watching right now, the main light of my studio, was all lit by a single Ninja 300. So that is all about the features, unboxing, and some other introduction about the Ninja 300. And I hope you can learn something from this video and help you better understand the COB light, what is a good COB light for our content creators. Okay, just want to give you a sum up on this Ninja 300 bundle. As you can see that the main drawback of this light is you cannot turn off the fan, but for the rest, the brightness, the light temperature, the wireless app control, and also the port design with the battery adapter as my lithium battery, the mini handle, make it portable and very useful for outdoor shootings. And with a nice design package, I can carry with me everywhere in my luggage box for outdoor shootings, for travel. And the Ninja 300 is perhaps one of the best choice for your main light. And don't forget, the V-Light also provide you with a Bowen connector that you can take the full advantage of your existed the Bowen diffuser box, the Bowen the soft box. So this accessory is also compatible with the Ninja 300 as well. But more importantly, you should notice that the battery adapter could also be doubled as a quick charge for this the F970, the lithium batteries, the WB2, the battery adapter. Because it's a single accessory, also it is surprisingly good for my content creation. And also with the amenable handle, you can see this is lightweight, it's quite small, it's quite bright, and it helps a lot in my content creation. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to thumb up, subscribe, and hit notification bell. So coming next, I'm gonna share with you a lot of great new update on 360 camera industries. So stay tuned in my next video, stay safe. Until next time, bye.